Hi guys, are you struggling to build muscle? Most importantly, are you struggling to build mass on your body? We're looking to increase that hypertrophy, feeling that you've really got a skinny frame. Then if you're a beginner, this is a beginner's routine. I want you to join me with this 30-minute home workout. All you're gonna need is a set of dumbbells and join me right now through this workout. Guys, you're here with How to China. I'm going to take you through that beginner 30-minute routine. Today is a chest and shoulder workout program to build mass. I'm going to take you step by step through the five exercises that we're going to do and show you how they should be performed and how the workout should be performed in order to help you build muscle mass. And just before I get started, in a couple of minutes, just going to need a few things for this workout. So you're doing it at home. If you haven't got a soft, comfortable floor, if you're not using carpet, you're on tiles or wooden flooring, make sure you grab yourself at least a mat if you can at home, or definitely purchase a mat. And also, you're going to need a chair. So I'm going to use my bench to imitate the upright position of a chair. So I have that. And as well, you will need dumbbells that you can work with. So if you need to, obviously, you may need to purchase some dumbbells if you haven't got so, but they are the best things you can have at home to still build muscle. And one last thing, we're just about to start the workout, but just before you do, I'd like you to pause the video directly here and make sure you click the link right above here. That will lead you to the 5-minute warm-up that you need to do just before going into this workout. You want to make sure your muscles are warmed up, they're ready prepared and ready to go. So you want to follow this push and leg warm-up. And once you've done that, I want you to come back to this video and continue from exactly this point, and we're going to begin that 30-minute workout. So let's start with the first exercise. I'm going to go into doing normal push-ups. That's a great exercise to start off with, especially as beginners. Your body weight is enough to build good quick chest. Repetitions ain't so much as important. We're trying to fail at the maximum amount of repetitions. So I'm going to do a normal push-up, giving us 1 minute work time and then taking 1 minute to rest. So you're going to make sure you've got your palms lined with your chest on every single press. And when you come forward, you want to come down with your chin coming forward and trying to bring as low as you can to the ground and try to get that chest to also touch the ground and keeping those hips up. So you're not dropping your hips into the ground and having a big arch in your back. You want to push through the palms. That's going to give you the most activation through the chest. And going slow and controlled with the reps. You're not here to burn extra calories. You need to focus just on breaking muscle into the muscles you're working. And just control that breathing. Breathe on the way down. Breathe out. So I did maximum amount of reps I could do within 1 minute working time. And now I'm gonna take a 1 minute rest. That's what we need to take when you're building muscle. You're trying to build mass. As a goal of mass building, you're trying to expend the least amount of calories during your workouts. The more you expend, the more you will struggle to build mass, because the amount of surplus calories that you need to take in, if you're burning lots of calories on top of the workouts, you have to make up for those in your eating time. And if you're working at longer durations, you're spending more time in the gym, then it's not giving you enough time to spend and work towards the diet. So a very important thing. So this is the way the workout is going today. It's a set-by-set workout and also doing exercise with 1 minute rest, completing 3 sets of each exercise and then moving so on and so on. So it's pretty slow paced, and that's the way you need to do it. When you're looking at building mass, it's very important. So that's 1 minute and we're going into the second set. So push-ups again. Again, slow, controlled, take your time. Just maxing the amount of reps you can do within 1 minute work time. If this gets difficult as a beginner, you might have that strength of the push-up, especially with great form. Drop the knees down. Keep that same line in the upper body. Again, bringing that chest down, chin down, and push. So make sure chin is still over the top, keeping those palms lined up with the chest. So you will realize how difficult push-ups can actually be. If you're doing them in proper form, controlled manner, keeping that palm alignment with your chest, They're actually a very difficult exercise. It's actually more difficult than actually just putting some weight on a bench press and pushing the weight, because you're not even gonna push close to the weight, your body weight. So it's very important to actually use push-ups in your mass building, and it's actually greater for your shoulder joint. So it's a lot safer, less pressure on it, because you're just pushing against gravity rather than pushing a barbell up. So I would definitely recommend push-ups in a mass building program. So again, you can take that 1 minute rest, and going in for the third and final set, and then moving on to another exercise. Again, we're gonna focus on chest after that again. So for the next one, we're gonna be focused on incline chest, and that's where our dumbbells will come in very useful. So in the last 3 seconds, let's go for third set. Like I said, it doesn't matter how many reps you do, it's just working in that time, trying to fatigue the muscle in the shortest space of time we can. All right, so taking that 1 more minute rest, at this time, you're really gonna feel chest is pretty fatigued. So the dumbbell, what you're gonna lift, is not gonna be very heavy. And I'm also gonna start with the toughest exercise you can with dumbbells. We're gonna now work our upper chest. Because the slight angle when you're doing push-ups, it dominates middle and the lower portion of your chest. But we wanna now take it right to the top, bringing us closer to the clavicle, working the upper chest. So I'm gonna grab my dumbbell set and show you the next exercise. Okay, this time the mat comes in very useful. I'm gonna do it against the wall. It'd be great if you can do it flat against the wall, this exercise. And a second pad or a cushion. So if you just get yourself a pillow, that'll work very great. Because I wanna build an incline position with this. We'll go behind my neck. And I'm gonna bring myself away from the wall. So coming slightly forward, just get your neck in a comfortable position, leaning a bit forward, and again the weight's here, right in between the shoulders here, pushing up, and breathing out the top. So bring those dumbbells all the way to the end of that chest, sitting right there near the armpit, and then push through, going straight up. Try not to let it back over your head, because you want to keep it in front of you, so you're still working chest and it doesn't become a shoulder press. You're going to very quickly feel this exercise, especially after doing push-ups, so it's great. You don't have to lift heavy, so you don't need tons of weight at home. So I'm going to take that minute rest, same concept with every single exercise we're going to do, 1 minute on, 1 minute off. And this is a great exercise you can do. You might even be able to do it on your chair, just slightly bringing yourself forward. You might find that's comfortable if you haven't got a position to put your back against on a wall, and obviously putting a cushion there just to rest your head on, just makes it look comfortable in exercise. You don't want to sprain your neck, so it's very important that you do have something behind the head. Like I said, you may be able to get away with it doing it on your chair. You've got enough space to sort of bring yourself forward and create an angle and kind of rest your head back on it. And then you'll be in the right position to put yourself into an incline chest press. Yeah, so great exercise. You're going to feel a good pump on the upper chest here. And just again, taking that rest. And obviously, don't forget to sip some water. At this point, it's a great time to usually go for something slightly sugary, which gets you through the routine and stops from your sugar just plummeting down. All right, let's go. You see that I got focus on pushing my chest out and trying to maintain that position. So try not let it drop where you're sort of bending your back towards the wall. You want to create that arch in the back, in the lower end. Again, at this stage, do not focus on repetition. You can have a guide of between 8 to 15 reps when we're trying to focus on that mass building, but it's not necessarily you finish on a specific rep. It's just getting that muscle fatigue, getting that breakdown to the muscle, and just focus on the 1 minute work time as much as you can get in, and then taking those minute breaks and going in again. Yet, you might find that you're actually decreasing in weight, so you might want to set yourself even a couple of dumbbells up that you've got at home, or even drop the weight at some point if you're using, depending on the type of dumbbells you're using at home. If it's not fixed hex weights like this, then it's going to be more like plates that you can change with spin locks or clips, then have some extra weight there and where you can reduce. So sometimes, especially if you're a complete beginner, just starting this out, then you're gonna find that your muscle fatigue is quite quick. The recovery period is not as quick. So you won't be able to lift the same weight repeatedly, set after set, where the reps decrease drastically, so that you might just need to take a couple of plates off as you do each set to sort of maintain those same sort of repetitions. So we go in for the last, final third set. Alright, so you can always take that pause and rest. If you think the muscle's completely burning out, can't do any more reps, just hold it there. Like I said, try to do as much as you can within that 1 minute work time. And after this one again, with that minute full change exercise, we're going to actually go into a flat version of the press now. So again, focusing right around the center line of our chest. So I'm going to stay with the mat, going a flat line position. And for this, I'm going to turn the mat on this one. The flat one is easier than doing the incline, so you might find this is where your weight will now slightly go up. I'm gonna go with the same weight. You can always try it with the same weight. Feels easy again, sort of high reps. You can know that if you feel that you need to lift a little bit more, that's when you can put the weight up. So let's go in three. You can actually still use that cushion or anything just to sort of raise your head a little bit, feel more comfortable with it. Okay, this one, lineman. What can commonly happen is alignment with the shoulders. You want to bring it forward till it lines up with the chest, and then going out wide and bring it sort of around the same sort of position. But on this flat version, it won't come as far down if you're doing it on the floor. So you're just bringing your arms down, just get those elbows to touch to the floor and just pushing back up. So there's another reason you're not getting the full range out of this one. Still effectively work the chest, you just might have to go a little bit heavier with the weight load. So at this time, you should feel a nice little pump in your chest. And sometimes it takes some time. Like I said, if you're a beginner, completely starting out, your muscles will take a little bit of time to engage and start to actually get that mind-muscle connection and really feel them. So don't think that you're not doing it correctly. As long as you're focusing on the right form position, you've got the alignment right when you're pressing through, and you're controlling the weight, it's not letting it sort of drop on you, controlling or push through too fast on your reps, you're working the muscle. But sometimes it just takes a little bit of time. It might take maybe even a month, couple of months to actually really feel the activation of your muscle and get that connection through. So let's go ahead, after that minute rest, straighten again. Still feeling light, and go for a heavier set. So I'm gonna go a little bit more up. So if you wanna know a way of understanding when to go up, for the meantime, if you're maxing more than 15, then definitely go up on the weight, because you don't wanna be pushing more than 15 and going into more endurance-based training. Just focus off around those repetitions, as I said before, somewhere between 8 and 15. 8 is your minimum, and then 15 is like your max. So when you're reaching 15 reps with the weights you're using, that's always a time to know that you need to go up in weight, so those reps come below of your failure point becomes lower than your 15 reps. So in 5, getting ready again. All right, so that makes up the 3 sets. That's also 3 exercises on the chest. Now I'm gonna focus on the 2 exercises on the shoulders. You'll notice when you're doing your chest exercises, it also does work the anterior delt. So you also, shoulders are getting worked on the front area here. That's why you don't need to do too many shoulder exercises. So focus on chest, shoulders partially worked. I'm only gonna do a couple exercises now to now hit the shoulders. So this is where now the chair will come in, keeping it. I wanna keep my bench obviously in that right angle position. So we're going in 10. Let's get this facing this way. We're going in for pike push-ups. So pike push-ups in an elevated position is gonna be the right ones for you to start with. Not a very easy exercise to do. So if you're going down on the floor, if you've got the strength, that's what you would do. But here, I wanna come all the way in as I can, get those arms extended out, on my toes at all times, push the hips up into the air, and then bring my head down, past my hands, and then pushing away. Again, just after doing all this chest work, you're gonna have some fatigue in these shoulder muscles. So it's not gonna be the easiest to do, but you need to find a higher elevation. If you're at home, you can do a higher elevation anywhere, sofa, worktops, anything like that, if even the level of chair that you're using is very difficult. So you're gonna work with this one, pushing your own body weight. And if you're getting past 15, doing it in this elevated position, then you lower yourself towards the floor more. So that is a great way we're adding in, doing the exercise at home. You may not have huge amounts of weight, especially if you're pushing over your shoulders. But again, it's another one that's greater on your joint as well. Again, you're pushing against rather than gravity, rather than using weights and pushing it and having too much force on the joint. So what that's gonna do is just imitating basically a shoulder press that you do if you did with the barbell. It does exactly the same thing, but you're using your body weight, and it's significantly actually harder using your body weight when actually doing this exercise, and it's a lot more effective. So taking that minute rest, I'm gonna go in again. And again, you set yourself in the best place depending how many reps you got there. If you did get about minimum 8, continue with it. If you're falling short, make sure you elevate yourself a little bit more. And don't forget again, sip some water through the workout. Here we go. Hips nice and high. Staying on the toes, ball of your feet, and then coming down. So as you can see, taking your time with the exercise. Don't try to work through it too far. It's a whole minute working set there. Like I said, you're trying to get the best out of it, keeping the great form all the way through. If you feel like you can't push it, then just rest that little bit, whether it's 10 seconds, 15 seconds, and then just try to continue to max out as many as you can. But do try to get past those 8 repetitions. If you're not, you just need to simplify the exercise just a little bit, like in this case, more elevation. Okay, just taking that rest, okay, grab some water. As you're getting a little bit more dehydrated through the workout, it's good. Drink a little bit more as you go, get close to the end, making sure maintaining hydration. And 10, going in for that last third set. So last one left, we're gonna go into a shoulder press this time. So you're gonna grab another set of dumbbells. I'm gonna do it flat against the wall. You can do it just sitting on your chair in upright position. So I'm gonna actually use the floor. It feels a lot more comfortable. And I find it's just a great way just kind of flat, keeping your back flat a little bit more. There we go, in the next couple of seconds. So I'm going right against the wall here. And one of actually the main reasons to do it, not just the back, it's actually gonna keep my arm position in a very good place. So I'm actually gonna push those elbows against the wall here so they can't come away and forward. Like if you wouldn't know if you're doing a general upright position, sitting on the chair or the bench, they're always gonna come a little bit forward. So here I'm actually pushing them, and now because I can touch against the wall, I know that it kind of remains in that good form. And I'm working the whole of my shoulders. And it doesn't just work your anterior delt. This way you're gonna get partial medial delt. So getting that middle area. Remember, there's three areas to hit on your shoulders. So you've got the rear, the medial, and the anterior delt. So this way I'm hitting two of those and just pushing those elbows a bit back. It's also gonna get your traps involved. So that long term will help you keep away from the shrugs. So I can feel pretty tough. You're gonna be a lot lighter with the dumbbells on this exercise than you have with any of the chest work you've just done. So even if you drop a lot lighter, go with a much lighter set. Again, slow and controlled. As you saw with the exercise there, you don't have to bring the dumbbells as low. You just wanna bring it around the eye level, and don't really bring it that you're bringing your elbows below your shoulder line. It doesn't have to go that low. That can actually increase issues to the shoulder joint, and you might find over time a slight pull or tension in that shoulder joint. So keep them more of a right angle when you have that starting position. Then that's the better position to use. You're still working the shoulders just as good if you bring it lower, but you're going to find that actually doing the whole full range can significantly increase some joint issue there. So try not to go that low. So we're going in again. Again, just pushing that back, get those shoulders to touch. Keeping those elbows far against the wall as possible. So that's the line here. Trying not to bring those elbows too far down. So keeping that dumbbell eye level. Very tough exercise, and you'll find that you're actually using more muscles. You'll actually feel it than if you just did the shoulder press sitting on that chair or leaning forward and keeping these elbows forward. And actually you can feel my traps engaging as well. A little bit heavier on the weight, so you obviously adjust your weight. Accordingly, I said minimum 8, maxing out that 15. But just gonna rest it just a little bit there and just complete a couple more reps. Okay, it's time. So rest it out. If you're sitting on the floor, just stay on the floor. You don't have to get up all the time. Like I said, the less you move, the better it is for you. Because that's the most important thing about mass building. You're not trying to do loads of amount of cardio. That's the last thing you want. The other one is you don't want long hours of workouts in a gym or at home. You don't want to be spending like an hour, hour and a half, two. Again, you're burning too much calories. Remember, the whole idea of mass building is you need more food, more calories in your body. So the less you burn, the better it is. So these fast-paced workouts, instead of 30-minute workouts, and doing them set by set, so you're not doing superset style at this stage, because you need to obviously build that surplus stage of calories. So once you can get there, but this is the way to work out. Make sure you're taking your time with your workouts, take a minute rest between each exercise, focus on one muscle group at a time. So keep it nice and slow, less calorie burn. Let's go for our last set. Well done, guys, if you got through that workout. Also want you to remember this is a 4-day split routine. So you're gonna have to complete another 3 workouts on top of this to make sure that you're working your entire body overall. You wanna create balance, you want muscle all over. You don't want different muscle groups having different proportion to your body where it looks kind of odd. So you wanna make sure you're working everything pretty evenly through the week, especially all the major muscles that we're gonna cover during the workouts. So make sure you follow through the whole 4-day split. You don't need to do any more than that, because if you're working 5 or 6 days a week in the gym thinking that's going to help you get bigger, well, it's not, because you're only going to burn a lot more calories. Like I was saying, the most important thing is to have a surplus diet that's going to give you the actual mass and size. You only want to work the minimum amount you need to in the gym. So they're going to be shorter workouts, around 30 minutes of work time that we're actually doing in these type of workouts, and making sure that you're hitting every single muscle group that is required to hit so you can build that mass. So least amount of work possible is around 4 days, and again, 30 minutes efficiently for your muscles to break down. And then the most important part is the recovery process. So all the days that you have off in between are great ideas. Instead of working out, making sure that you're eating those surplus amount of calories, and it's gonna help you start to gain some muscle mass. So the biggest chore that you're going to find that becomes is actually the amount of eating that you have to do. So you're always going to be focusing on eating pretty much all the time. So if you have an opportunity to get some calories down your body, make sure you take advantage of that. Don't sit around and don't feel that if you're not hungry, that it's not time for you to eat. You need to focus and even strategically plan your time and your day to day. So make sure that you're eating in a certain number amount of hours if you're possible. If you have plenty of time free and where you normally skip meals, make sure you add another meal in. That's the most important things that you're gonna need to do to actually increase that calorie surplus. If you guys are really struggling with your nutrition and you need some support, I'm actually gonna drop the link down below. If you click on that link, you'll find my calorie support system, which is actually nutritional coaching. So you're gonna liaise directly with me where I'm gonna actually help you build that calorie surplus. For some of you that want some recommendations for some really good equipment, I'm gonna drop a few links down below so you can check those out for the equipments that I'm using, but I'm also gonna give you some nice good budget options that are best for home use. So that's it for today. If you have any questions, please comment in the comment section down below and let me know actually how you got on with the workout today. And if you wanna view the next workout routine, you can check out one of these thumbnails right here. But for now, that's it from me, guys. You've been watching Hydro China, helping you build muscle and staying the course, increasing that muscle growth. Stay strong.